Welcome to Unleash, a Tricom podcast that delves into topics that impact your business, from leadership, teamwork, and personal development, all are essential components to any successful organization. Our goal is to provide valuable insight, inspire, and motivate individuals for personal and professional growth, while promoting self-reflection and a growth mindset by sharing practical tools and resources. We are back exploring attitudes and the influence and impact they have on our lives and our work environment. How we interact with others, attitude shapes our experiences and determines the outcomes we achieve. Back joining me today on this subject is Amanda Jadro, Tricom's Director of Credit. Hi, Amanda.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning. How are you today?
Wonderful.
Great. Well, thanks for coming back and joining me.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Julianne.
I'm excited to keep on talking about this subject. We love this subject. We love the book.
Yes.
So, first of all, we should talk about our last podcast. We mentioned John Maxwell's book, Attitude 101. You want to talk about John a little bit?
Yeah, absolutely. So, John Maxwell, in his 101 book series, he's a renowned leadership expert. He offers a comprehensive collection of practical principles and strategies to enhance leadership skills, communication, personal growth, and overall effectiveness. You can find his books everywhere and highly recommend that you see what he has to offer.
Excellent. Good. So today we want to really talk about the power of positive attitude, correct?
We do.
So let's look at, first of all, can attitude determine how far one can go and really the journey, the success of their journey? Do you feel that it helps them?
I do. I think that it is a limiting factor for some. You can only go so far with your leadership and growth within a company or an organization. I feel like those with really great attitudes have a longer runway in a company, just mostly because of all of the interactions that you need to have with both staff, clients, prospects, and your attitude makes a big difference in how those people perceive you and how much they enjoy working with you. So attitude is essential.
It's funny because in the book, he talks about no limit people. And I kind of tie that into this whole section about it can determine your success in your journey. And I'm one of those no limit people, I think, because it's one of those that says, I don't accept normal limitations of life like most people do. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't mean like I'm a daredevil. It's just I'm unwilling to accept the accepted. And so because that's what most people do. They just accept the accepted just because it's accepted. Mm-hmm. No, it's I want to push the boundaries. Mm-hmm. And that's the journey of having that success, is pushing the boundaries, is pushing it just outside. Here's my limit, and I want to push it even further. And I do that both in my personal growth, my professional growth, my journey as an athlete, because I still do stuff like Tough Mudder. I'm doing that again this fall. Mm-hmm. And I'm always trying to push my boundaries. And I think that is a mindset of just trying to be more successful and achieving more.
Yeah, don't limit yourself, because right, anything is possible. One of the things that, as I read through this book, he talks about the bumblebee. And
yep,
I thought that was interesting, because yep, I didn't know the story behind the bumblebee not being scientifically, should not be able to fly,
right,
just based on the size of the bumblebee and the wingspan.
Right, so small. Right. It's amazing.
And yet the bumblebee flies.
Right.
So it's one of those things that's like, it's a good reminder for me or be a bumblebee. Really,
right, right. You're right. It's really, that was a great analogy in the book.
Yeah.
I love that, because it's true. I never knew that they really scientifically should not be able to do what they do.
Yeah, and it's just a good reminder for myself. It's one of those triggers. Sometimes mm-hmm, those are really helpful just to kind of help shake you out of whatever you might be contemplating here, and know that, hey, there's no limit, there's no boundary. It's only what I set for myself in my mind.
Right, right. So the other thing about power of positive attitude, we talked about in our last session a little bit, but attitudes have the power to lift you up, have the power to lift up the team, I should say, and to also tear down a team. Let's talk about that. What are your comments or your observations in the past with working with teams that with positive attitudes and negative attitudes?
A positive attitude will be really important for a team
mm-hmm.
to be successful. Teams can't be successful without everyone working together and having a positive can-do attitude where as a team, they know that they can achieve really great things. They can get through troubles and they can rely on each other. And that positivity helps you get there. If there's that negative environment, you're self-limiting again.
Right.
You're saying that you are not going to be able to, or maybe you don't want to do these things, and it's going to be really hard to rally people around to get that accomplished.
Right, because doesn't he show in the book, you can have all the talent you want in a team, but if you don't have the right attitude within that team is not going to be successful.
That's right.
So the great team with the great attitude is, the great talent with the great attitude produces a great team.
That's right.
And we have seen that recently, and we're going to bring her in our next session,
mm-hmm.
is really an employee that recently became an employee at Tricom,
mm-hmm.
who has this phenomenal energy and attitude.
Mm-hmm.
And I've said, Amanda, we have to bring her in on the podcast. She just as, her energy is unbelievable.
Mm-hmm.
It's, you can't not have a great day when you meet her. There's actually two new employees, both Jenny and Larry. They're just amazing people. They always have this energy when they come in the day that just uplifts you. And Jenny does some really unique things, so we'll talk about her. But what she has done to that team, because the team has always been talented,
mm-hmm.
but she's got this great energy and great attitude, and she's brought that team, I think, up to another whole new level.
She has.
And
yeah.
It's great to see. It
it's
really
wonderful.
Is. Yeah.
And I think the team is enjoying their work environment so
mm-hmm.
much more having her as a part of their team. So
yep.
it's a pretty amazing thing what one person can do.
Right, right. Let's talk about bad attitudes. Can they compound fast, faster than the good ones? Can they destroy a team faster than the good one?
They
it
do.
Seems like they do.
They do, yeah. I believe that as well. As much as you like to see how much the positive attitude has affected our team here internally, the negative attitude will compound and affect people even quicker. It will bring those positive people's energy down. It will, really affect the team, and people won't enjoy their work any longer. They
mm-hmm.
won't enjoy, what they're doing for their clients and customers just because they're in an environment that is not a happy, safe place.
Right. So I think what we're saying is to really address the bad attitudes, the rotten attitudes right away within your organization. Don't let them sit, right?
Absolutely. And it can be tricky. It's a difficult thing to
mm-hmm.
address someone's behavior, but it's something as a manager and a leader, it's a very important thing to do. And it's good to kind of understand where the attitude is formed, where does it come from, to better understand how you might be able to help them. And some of the things that they talk about is just your temperaments. They also talk in the book about just your environment being a great contributor to what your attitude is.
Mm-hmm.
So your environment as you grow up, your childhood, your home life, all of those things are carried with you everywhere you go,
mm-hmm.
including into your workspace.
Right. So I think sometimes we just need to just talk with people, check in with them and find out what are they going through in their life.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's a life situation that they're going through. They're going through a bad season and that's what's bringing their attitude down and they need someone to talk to. And we just don't understand that. And they just need space and we can give them resources and help. And that's all that is needed to get them lifted back up.
Yep.
And then we can give them maybe some other tools and some other different resources to contribute to get them out of that bad season right now.
That's right.
Right. Cause we don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
We don't understand what's going on outside of work. There's a lot and there's a lot of pressures out there.
That's right. People bring their whole selves to work every single day.
Mm-hmm.
You can't compartmentalize things that are happening in everyone's life. And it's encouraged to bring your whole self to work. Be who you are all the time. Sometimes that's good and sometimes that brings you
mm-hmm.
some of that
mm-hmm.
challenging behaviors.
Right. So also with positive attitude and the power of it, what about surrounding yourself with either negative people or positive people? I always found that it was great to try to really surround myself with good people who are more positive.
Mm-hmm.
The ones who are pessimistic and always oh no, the glass is empty, you know, or half empty. You know, because for me, I feel like they do bring me down.
Yeah, you're a product of your environment. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So, you know, who you choose to hang out with is really who you end up becoming, you know, whether you like it or not. So just make sure that you're choosing those people who uplift you and bring you to a better space in life. And then to try and stay away from those people that you are feeling are bringing you down. Mm-hmm. But just being able to recognize that.
Right.
And, you know, not participate in those types of conversations with people, you know, that aren't uplifting you.
Right, right. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about a couple of things that we, both of us do, or maybe we read in the book, that we do to shift our attitude. Mm-hmm. When we notice that we're having a bad day and we know that our attitude is in a bad spot. Mm-hmm. What do you do that maybe you put your mindset to have a good attitude?
Most of the time it's changing my perspective, particularly at work. It's the easiest, quickest thing for me to be able to do is to just change the way I'm looking at something, see that challenge as an opportunity, try to reframe it in my mind, and then just to go ahead and move forward and not let that affect me and choose mm-hmm. to change my attitude, because I think attitude is a choice. And when I know that my attitude is kind of controlling me, I need to stop and take a moment and choose a different attitude.
Right, right. Yeah, I have to look at the situation. I got to take 5 or 10 minutes to investigate, you know, what's going on. Mm-hmm. Why am I in this? What is it? Is it the stress? Is it a workload? Is it family? Is it something? What is it?
Yep.
And then can I change that? Can I handle that at that point in time? You know, is there a way to eliminate it? Or do I need to say, okay, I can't deal with it now. There's nothing I can do with it right now. Yep. So I'm gonna compartmentalize it and put it away for now mm-hmm. and decide to change my attitude. And I'm going to have to deal with that tonight or whatever.
That's right.
You know, and then there's another way. The other thing I did, and I bought this book for both for myself, and it's the 5-minute journal, I believe it is, or 5-minute journal. And I bought it for a colleague of mine as well. And you start in the morning, and one of the things you do is list the things you're thankful for and grateful for. And, you know, and it really does, when you do that in the morning, it really changes your whole mindset. When you wake up and you spend a couple minutes just listing the things you're thankful for, it makes you look at things differently.
Yeah, it centers you.
Mm-hmm.
It reminds you how blessed you really are and to be thankful for all the good things that you have going, because there are always many good things. And sometimes you're just not focusing on that. You're focusing on the challenge or the difficulty and missing, you know, where you've come from. You know, they talk about your attitude is a product of yesterday, right? So things that happened yesterday affects you today. And mm-hmm. these are things that are part of you and you're bringing, you know, with you everywhere you go.
Mm-hmm. Other ones, any other thing that you do to change it? Sometimes I listen to music.
Yep.
I'll put music on in my office.
I like music.
I'll put, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. I also like just meditating, taking a couple minutes and just mm-hmm. take some deep breaths. Deep breaths calm you, and there's like a physiology that happens that it literally relaxes your body. So that is very helpful for me and for my kids, by the way. I do that for them all the time. They take 5 deep breaths, calm down. What's the real issue? You know,
mm-hmm.
big deal, little deal, just trying to kind of reframe that. And exercise is another wonderful way to help reduce some of that stress.
Exercise is big. If I don't run in the morning, mm-hmm. thank God I ran this morning, but if I don't run in the morning, it really does change my day.
It does.
The exercise is a big thing in the morning.
Those endorphins, mm-hmm. and it does make a big difference. Mm-hmm. So those are some small things that you can do in short amounts of time that mm-hmm. I think help a lot.
Even if you can't run or exercise, take a 10-minute walk.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in the morning or during the day, if you're having a bad day and you're having a situation where you're really stressed or your attitude has deteriorated and you know that you're bad. And I've got to do that more when I can feel that my door has been like a revolving door, mm-hmm. is I just have to put my do not disturb, go outside and take a 10-minute walk.
Mm-hmm.
Because that 10 minutes will, you know,
calm
and then will calm you down. And then maybe in my mind go, okay, now here, what am I thankful for again?
Yep.
You know, and it will reset your brain. It really will.
Mm-hmm.
And then you come back all refreshed. Because we do live a very stressful life. All of us do.
We do.
There's a lot going on in our lives. So we need to do that. And I think if it's really bad, then you need to talk to people. You need to talk to somebody. Find somebody you can confide in that you know that they will hold that personally and they will be confidential with it.
Right.
And you can have those confidential and great discussions with. So those are the things I think we do, right?
Yeah, and it helps a lot.
Great. I think that's good. My last one would be scripture. I do a lot of scripture reading or reading. Reading's a big thing.
Yeah, reading in general.
Right.
It's always good to open your mind and to hear new things, new ideas, new perspectives. And sometimes that is all it needs to just kind of get you out of whatever you're focused on to let you think about some other things. Another thing that I have found real enjoyment in is volunteering. When I'm able to help other people and do other things for the community or things that are important to me, those are things that help me feel very grateful for the things that I have and that I'm able to do some of these things for other people. So for me, that's a really big deal.
Right.
Something that's really helpful.
At the end, give yourself grace. We're not perfect. So give yourself grace. When you find that you have a bad attitude, don't get down on yourself so hard. Just work on shifting that mindset, get yourself back in a good attitude, but don't beat yourself up, give yourself grace. I think that's about it, right?
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Amanda, for joining me again.
Yes.
And for sharing your thoughts and experiences on attitude. And for all of you joining us today again, join us for the next episode as we explore developing a great attitude. And we look forward to having you listen, and thank you.